It's a bit of a lifestyle car based on the M260. Come on. Mr. Police Officer won't let us go any faster than this. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are taking a look at the all-new Mercedes-AMG CLA 35 4MATIC. So, the four-door coupe version of the A-Class, but you now also have the A-Class Saloon and the CLA Shooting Brake. So now, including the hatchback, we've got four different A-Class body styles, which is a lot. So today we're taking a look at this one. I'll show you around it, show you the spec we've got it in, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for a quick blast over there. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to receive updates when we upload a new video, and check us out on Instagram at Autotop.nl. So what is the CLA? Well, it's the four-door coupe of the hatchback. So it's pretty small, it looks cool, it's a bit of a lifestyle car, even according to Mercedes. So it's basically the cooler, more distinguished version of the hatchback. Okay, the spec we've got it in. Well, we've got this mountain gray, which is a matte gray, which is not my favorite. I think the matte color thing has had its peak and it should be gone by now. But, you know, maybe it's a taste thing. What is AMG? Well, of course, the front bumper with these blades in there. We also have the... This thing is haunted, or what? So, these blades, this car also has the AMG night pack, so it has a lot of black accents, little splitter, just a more aggressive front end altogether, with the new headlights, of course. The new CLA compared to the old CLA is a bit longer, quite a bit wider and lower. So that does help it proportion wise, because the old CLA, I was not the biggest fan of that proportion wise. I always thought it looked a bit weird from some angles. This, I think it looks better. It has, you know, it's closer to the dimensions, the proportions of a CLS, which is a handsome car. So we've got AMG wheels. This is an upgrade to 19 inch. As standard, you get 18 inch with silver AMG brake calipers behind that, and some lovely Michelin Pilot Sport 4S tires. Turbo 4MATIC badge, some more black around the windows, mirror cap, little side skirt as well, and a little AMG spoiler. This is actually a big improvement. I've seen a couple of CLSs with a similar spoiler, and it absolutely changes the look of the rear end. It makes it far more good looking. We also have an AMG rear bumper with a diffuser and a dual exhaust as well. An AMG badge, of course, CLA 35 badge. The new rear lights, which look pretty cool. So guys, you can rate the exterior of this car in the top right corner. Let us know what you think from 1 to 5. And of course, you can elaborate in the comments to let us know why you think what you think. Okay, and with that, we'll take a look at the engine. So there is the power plant of the CLA 35. It's a 2-liter four-cylinder turbo engine based on the M260. So it's based on the A250 engine rather than being a true purpose-built AMG engine like the A45 has. But it does have 306 horsepower and 400 newton meters, which is a nice amount of power for this size car, of course. 0 to 100, 4.9 seconds. Top speed of 250 kilometers an hour. But that top speed, we will come back to that when we get to the Autobahn, because there's some strange stuff going on with this car and its top speed. So let's check out the interior. We've got these AMG seats, which are not great. They are pretty hard, not that supportive. But the rest of the interior is, of course, ahead of everyone else for this class. It is absolutely beautiful with these gorgeous vents, with the beautiful new steering wheel, with the new configurable buttons and the drive selector, of course. But this steering wheel, this basically trickled down from the S-Class and the GT 63 four-door to an A-Class, which is pretty crazy. It's absolutely beautiful with perforated leather as well, an AMG logo and a 12 o'clock marker. When we drove the regular A35 hatchback, we didn't have this. So I don't know if this is now available in the A35 as well, but it is available in the CLA 35 and it's really cool. But we drove the A45 recently and you could configure a lot more. So they did try to differentiate between the A35 and the A45 there. But this car does have the adaptive dampers, so we can actually change that between Comfort, Sport and Sport Plus. We can do the traction control. We can switch to manual mode for the gearbox, the 7-speed dual clutch gearbox, start stop and traction control again. And over here we can switch to Sport Plus, which actually also opens a valve in the exhaust. But you can't, there's no exhaust button anywhere. There's an empty button for it. So it does have a valve exhaust, but you can't operate it separately. You just have to go to Sport Plus. And you also can't go to race mode, like in the A45 we drove. Other than that, you can get the AMG performance seats, which are a lot more sporty, but are also a lot harder. So the seat options in this car, not great, if you ask me. Before we take it for a drive, I just want to let you know that we've got a new watch. It's called the Eiger Day Date. It has a day and date indication, as you can see, with a night blue dial, limited to 30 pieces with a nice rubber strap. A bit minimalistic and a bit sporty, so I hope you guys like it. You can check it out in the top right corner to see which numbers are still available, because each number is on the back of the watch, so they are individually numbered. Okay, and with that out of the way, let's take it for a drive towards the Autobahn to see what it's like on a road like this. It's a little bit damp. So we are in Sport Plus and I'll put the traction control in sport mode as well. So we've got some fake sound coming through the speakers in Sport Plus mode as well. And some pops on the exhaust. The tail end sliding a little bit, but the formatting system in this car will send up to 50% to the rear, so and up to 100% to the front. So it's basically a front-wheel drive car, unless you need more power to go to the rear. The gearbox, when you change gears manually in Sport Plus mode, the upshift is absolutely fine, but the downshift, there's a little delay in that, which I don't really like. It feels a bit like the Mercedes gearboxes of a couple of years ago. They also had this delay in the pedal, which is not great. But of course, we have launch control as well. So we'll put the gearbox in drive again. We're in Sport Plus mode. Just put your foot on the brake, full throttle, and race start is available. And there we go. And that's 100 kilometers an hour in 4.9 seconds, which is quick. The only thing this car really lacks when you drive it on this road is a bit of character. The A45 feels so much more purpose-built and more aggressive compared to this. I'll just stop here for like 10 seconds so you guys can check out the ambient lighting, which is always really nice. And we can also change the color on this ambient lighting. So we'll go for the blue one because that is always the most bright one. during the day. There we go. That is really bright. I actually made a night POV last night, and this is way too bright to drive at night, because you just it just shines in your eyes and it's really bright. So don't do that at night, but I'll keep it on for now. We also have the AMG performance exhaust, which is optional. But it's not that expensive. But if I were you, I would keep that money in your pocket and save it for something aftermarket, because it's not really that impressive. You get some little crackles on the overrun, but it's just not that impressive. Let's be honest. Traction is pretty impressive though, because it is, well, quite damp today, and you don't really feel that unless you really push it. It's absolutely fine getting the power down, so that is a very positive. It also means that it's not that exciting. It's like a VW Golf R from Mercedes AMG. It does the job, but it won't really get your juices flowing excitement-wise. Okay, so here we are at the Autobahn, and I hope we have enough space for me to show you what I meant earlier. Oh, it's very empty behind me. Just going to get some space here. While we are doing that, we also have the TrackBase app on this car, which is an option. And there is a very cool feature in there. When you drive this car on track, I don't know how useful this actually is and how many people will actually drive this car on track. But anyway, when you drive it on track, you can use the augmented reality from the MBUX system to project the perfect racing line in front of you on the screen, which is pretty cool. I mean, on the GTR Pro, that's awesome. On a CLA 35, not really necessary, but it's a cool feature anyway. So let's see, that's 230. I'm in Sport Plus, as you know by now. The suspension is in Sport Plus as well. But this is absolutely fine. It's still quite comfortable. So even in Sport Plus, it's relatively comfortable, but you really have to have this car in Sport Plus, because if you have it in comfort mode, it just dies. The gearbox is really laggy and everything just, it's a bit boring. So when you keep it in Sport Plus, everything is awake. The exhaust sounds a bit better as well. The gearbox pays attention as well. So here we go again. As you can see, you need a bit of space to reach the top speed. Okay, here we go. Come on. You really do feel the difference between this and an A45. That engine is just so much more powerful and so much punchier. Okay, here we go. That's 249, that's 250. On the speedo, and it won't go any faster than that. That's the limiter. And that is not 250 GPS speed, that is 250 kilometers on the speedo. So GPS, that's actually 245 kilometers an hour, and it won't go any faster. While Mercedes AMG says that this car has a top speed of 250 kilometers an hour. So that is a bit weird, and it's not really correct. I think we had the same problem with the A35. So maybe they just decided that 250 kilometers an hour on the speedo is the top speed, but it's a bit weird. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the most awesome and weird things about the German Autobahn. We've got a police car in front of us and we are driving 180, 170 kilometers an hour. And when he goes to the right, we can actually overtake him. If he goes to the right, because sometimes they like to keep you behind them. Like this one. So guys, you can rate the performance of this car in the top right corner from 1 to 5. Let us know what you think about the performance of this car. You can also check out the Autobahn run we did with this car with our Draghi GPS performance data in it. You can click in the top right corner right now for that video. Because Mr. Police Officer won't let us go any faster than this. And we are also approaching the border. So I think I'll just end this video here. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right here. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye.